हेलो, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट कार्डियोलॉजी टुडे। वी विल डिवाइड कार्डियोलॉजी इनटू थ्री लेक्चर्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द सिम्टम्स एंड क्लिनिकल प्रेजेंटेशन फॉर द कार्डियोलॉजी। देन वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंट एग्जामिनेशन एंड इन्वेस्टिगेशन यूजुअली डन इन द कार्डियोलॉजी पोर्शन। एंड एट लास्ट वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द डिजीज in the cardiology. So in this section we are going to study about the symptoms or the major clinical presentation seen in the cardiology section. So we are going to study at first about the symptom, and under symptom heading we will study about the chest pain, palpitation, syncope, kind stroke breathing, and cyanosis. So these are the most common presentation usually found in the cardiology department. So we will start from the chest pain. And usually the chest pain is the most frequently asked question in the bedside region. So first of all, one should know what are the differential diagnosis of the chest pain. We can remember this chest pain, the differential diagnosis of the chest pain, by dividing the organ which are involved in the chest pain. So at first and the most frequently involved organ is the cardiac cause. It can be aorta, can be abdominal cause, lungs, esophagus, musculoskeletal like rib fracture or costochondritis. It can be hyperadrenal state, adrenal gland, or some of the toxin like poisoning in case of the cocaine. So starting from the cardiac cause, what are the most frequently presentation or the disease which involves chest pain? It can be either angina, myocardial infarction, mitral valve prolapse, pericarditis, or hypertrophic cardiomyopathy also presents with the chest pain. And in aorta section, one should know that the aortic dissection and aortic stenosis and regurgitation also presents sometime with chest pain. And under abdominal cause, one should know that the complication of the peptic ulcer is perforated type of abdominal ulcer or peptic ulcer. So when there is perforation in the complication, as a complication of peptic ulcer, that can cause a chest pain. And pancreatitis and cholecystitis also causes chest pain. Pancreatitis and cholecystitis. And regarding lungs cause, chest pain is usually seen in pleurisy, pneumothorax and hydrothorax. And under esophagus topic, one should know that if there is any spasm of the esophagus or spasm or during GERD or any reflux disease related to the esophagus can cause chest pain, means they present with the chest pain. So under musculocutaneous topic, it can be caused due to the costochondritis, fracture of rib, okay, and adrenal, if adrenal gland secretes excessive amount of hyperadrenalism, causes chest pain, and cocaine toxin can also cause chest pain. So according to the, we can study the presentation of the chest pain in the respective disease topic. So this was just for the differential diagnosis of the chest pain. Now we will proceed to the next main chief complaint of the cardiology section. So that is kine stroke breathing. The next complaint is kine stroke. Kine stroke is nothing but a progressive or cyclic pattern of hyper ventilation, which is followed by a apnea. Suppose that a person is hyperventilating for few minutes, for few seconds, and then he suddenly goes to an apneic phase. So that is called as kine stroke breathing. Kine stroke breathing. So if we will make, suppose that this person is respirating, this was inspiration and the downfall is the expiration. So he is hyperventilating, and suddenly after hyperventilation he undergoes apnea, and again he starts hyperventilation, which is again followed by a apneic phase, and this cyclic pattern of breathing is called as kine stroke breathing. Okay, and what is the reason behind the this sequential hyperapnea, hyperventilation followed by the apneic phase? This is apnea. This is hyperventilation. So what is the reason? Suppose that a person was under the influence of hypoxia or hypoxemia. Hypoxemia will precipitate hyperventilation. Obviously he will start breathing breathing heavily, and which precipitated hyperventilation. And due to the hyperventilation, he throws away all the carbon dioxide, called as after hyperventilation, when hyperventilation was there, it causes CO2 washout. And this CO2 washout causes the depression of the respiratory center. Depression of respiratory center in the CNS, hypothalamus. As a result, due to the depression of the respiratory center, the person undergoes a apneic phase. Okay, and after sometimes, when the CO2 level restores, again the person starts hyperventilating, because still the hypoxia or hypoxemia is not relieved. So he starts hyperventilation. So this was the mechanism behind the kine stroke breathing. And what are the disease which presents with kine stroke breathing? It is usually disease of heart, disease of lungs, and disease of CNS. Under heart, one should know that congestive heart failure or severe heart failure can cause kine stroke breathing. Uremia syndrome. Uremia can cause chronic hypoxia, as we studied. Chronic hypoxia, or there can be under lungs topic. Under lungs, it can be due to the severe pneumonia. And CNS, if there is any increase in intracranial pressure, or there is trauma in the CNS, or excessive hemorrhage can precipitate hypoxia, or any narcotic drug abuse. So these were the cause behind the kine stroke breathing. Now going to the next symptom, that is the palpitation. Look, palpitation simply means the awareness of the heartbeat. But during bedside, the next question comes forward, that if a person undergoes a heavy strenuous exercise, then obviously everybody feels his heartbeat. Everybody is aware about his heartbeat. So is that a palpitation? Then the answer is no, that is not the palpitation, because everybody misses a word in the definition of the palpitation, that is uncomfortable awareness of the heartbeat. Look, this uncomfortable is the most important word in the definition of the uncomfortable awareness of on heartbeat is called as palpitation. Okay, and the occurrence does not necessarily means that there is any arrhythmia. Okay, this is not always associated with arrhythmia. There are lot other causes for the palpitation. So now the next question is, what are the disease that can cause palpitation? So we can divide the disease. Obviously that palpitation is usually caused by the cardiac cause. So what are the cardiac disease that can precipitate palpitation in the patient? Then that is, look, the kind of stroke was like this, means hyperventilation followed by apneic phase, again hyperventilation. So one should remember this. And chest pain, we studied about the differential diagnosis. Now coming to the cause for the palpitation, what are the causes of palpitation? So the cause can be divided into, first of all, almost all of the arrhythmia can present with palpitation. So all the arrhythmia we will study in the next section. And the other is the high cardiac output disease, like in anemia, AV fistula, beriberi, fever, Paget disease, the other cardiac anomalies like congenital anomaly, we can remember it as congenital anomaly in the heart. And palpitation can be also precipitated by drug abuse. The drug can be either alcohol, amphetamine, anticholinergic drugs, and it can be metabolic. It can be psychiatric cause or some of the other cause can be strenuous physical exercise is also a physiological cause, but it should be uncomfortable. The exercise, the palpitation, the awareness should be uncomfortable to the patient after the strenuous activity. So that is included in a physiological type of palpitation. Okay, so what are the types of the arrhythmia? We will study in the next section. So high cardiac output, one should remember that the under high cardiac output it is anemia, beriberi, or fever, Paget's disease. So these are the high cardiac output state of a person that can cause palpitation. So congenital anomalies, regarding congenital anomaly, it can be either patent ductus arteriosus, it can be mitral valve prolapse, ventricular septal defect, or ASD, atrial septal defect, any stenosis of the aortic or pulmonary region. Drug, what are the drug that can precipitate palpitation? It can be either alcohol, it can be amphetamine, anticholinergic, means all the drug that can increase sympathetic activity. And caffeine and nicotine also causes palpitation. Caffeine, nicotine, metabolic state, suppose that a person is hyperthyroid, means increased thyroid, increased adrenal, decreased glucose. So these are the condition that can cause palpitation. And under psychological, if a person is under stress, emotional stress or anxiety, major depression or panic, patient undergoes palpitation. So So these were the cause for the palpitation. Now the next and the last symptoms in the cardiology usually is the syncope. First of all, one should know what is syncope. So syncope is the, there are three important points in syncope. One should remember that syncope is comprised of generalized weakness of the muscle. Okay, there is weakness in the muscle, and the other is loss of postural tone. Syncope. Weakness of muscle. The tone of the muscle is lost. And the third point is he is unable to stand. And the fourth point is loss of consciousness. So the muscle, there is obvious weakness in the muscle, and the tone of the muscle is lost, and he is unable to stand along with loss of consciousness. So these four features or the component are the component of the syncope. Now one should know what are the causes or what are the classification of the syncope. So syncope can be precipitated or caused by the vasovagal reflex. Okay, vasovagal reflex means any syncope that is influenced by the vagus nerve. When the vagus nerve activates, then he or she undergoes marked fall in the atrial pressure and peripheral vascular resistance. So as a result, the heart rate undergoes, heart rate slows down, and the cardiac output is insufficient to meet the tissue perfusion. As a result, he or she undergoes syncope. Means what were the precipitating factor for the vasovagal reflex? That was low cardiac output, usually caused by the marked fall in the atrial pressure and peripheral resistance increases via vagus nerve. And what are the conditions that can precipitate or stimulate vagus nerve? That is usually emotional stress, overcrowding, blood loss. So these are the important, anemia or fever. Okay, this was the first type of syncope. Now the other are the cardiac syncope. Suppose that if there is the heart is itself unable to pump the blood to the, usually syncope is caused due to the low cardiac output by the heart. Suppose that there is any heart disease that can cause that is causing low cardiac output. As a result, the blood flow to the tissue becomes low, and that causes less blood flow to the even the cerebral region, and precipitates syncope. And what are the diseases in the cardiac region? Due to low cardiac output. Okay, and the disease that can cardiac disease that can stimulate syncope are complete heart block. It can be arrhythmia, or it can be stenosis of any valve like mitral or aortic, cardiomyopathies. So these are the important cardiac disease that can stimulate the syncope, cardiac type of syncope. The third type of syncope is the orthostatic or postural. So what is the reason behind the orthostatic syncope? Usually when the person suddenly gets up after lying position, then, or even if he is standing, even if he is standing for a long period, suddenly let's suppose that he is moving now. So there is loss in the vasoconstriction reflex. This is the point, okay? Loss in the vasoconstriction reflex in the lower limb. लोअर लिम का जो भासो कंस्ट्रिक्शन रिफ्लेक्स होता है वो लॉस हो गया, तो इसके कारण क्या हो जाएगा कि हिज ब्लड वेसल डू नॉट अंडरगोज भासो कंस्ट्रिक्शन एंड द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ द ब्लड इज नॉट मेट बाय द टिश्यू. एज अ रिजल्ट ही गोज टू अ सिंकोप स्टेट. एंड व्हाट आर द कॉमन कॉजेज बिहाइंड द ऑर्थोस्टेटिक? This can be either physiological, this is physiological, or it can be idiopathic, drug induced, diabetic nephropathy में, neuropathy में दिखता है, और hemorrhage में. It can be idiopathic, diabetes mellitus के patient में दिखता है, neuropathy if he has undergone neuropathy caused by the diabetes, और hemorrhage के केस में. Okay? ही अंडरगोज ऑर्थोस्टेटिक. तो अदर टाइप ऑफ सिंकोप आर सेरेब्रोवास्कुलर डिजीज, CNS का कोई डिजीज था, एज अ रिजल्ट द CNS डू नॉट अंडरगोज कंप्लीट परफ्यूजन, दैट कैन प्रेसिपिटेट सिंकोप इन अ पर्सन. सो एंड द मिसलिनियस टाइप और द अदर्स में आपको याद रखना होगा, इफ अ पर्सन अंडरगोज कैरोटिड साइनस का मसाज करा रहा है, मतलब कि नेक रीजन में अगर सेविंग के टाइम में कैरोटिड साइनस के साइट पर कोई भी प्रेशर पड़ जाए तो दैट कैन प्रेसिपिटेट सिंकोप. और पर्सन कैन अंडरगो सिंकोप आफ्टर कॉफ, सो कॉफ स्टिमुलेटिंग सिंकोप, मिक्चुरेशन सिंकोप, ओके. हाइपर वेंटिलेशन और हिस्टेरिक फेंटिंग इज ऑल्सो सीन इन सम टाइप ऑफ सिंकोप. एंड हाइपर वेंटिलेशन, सो दीज आर द सम ऑफ द रिस्क फैक्टर और द प्रेसिपिटेटिंग फैक्टर फॉर द सिंकोप. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द सिम्टम्स मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंटली प्रेजेंटिंग इन द कार्डियोलॉजी. We will study these all the disease in a very nice and broad way in the disease section. So we are done with the cardiology symptom, in which we studied about the chest pain, kind of stroke breathing, hyperventilation followed by a apneic phase, palpitation uncomfortable, what was important in this section. And under syncope we studied four components of the syncope: weakness of muscle, tone is lost, unable to stand, and loss of consciousness. And we studied about the palpitation, all the causes of the palpitation, and these are the causes for the syncope. So now the last presenting feature in the cardiology is the cyanosis. We will study cyanosis from its definition and types. We will differentiate it into central cyanosis and peripheral cyanosis, and we will thoroughly discuss about this. So, cyanosis is usually the hemoglobin is in which form? That is oxygenated type of hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is always bound to the oxygen form. So, this is called as oxygenated hemoglobin. Okay, but If the hemoglobin is not able to be oxygenated and deoxygenated, then it is called as deoxygenated hemoglobin. And suppose that this deoxygenated hemoglobin concentration is greater than 5 gram per deciliter, then it is called as cyanosis. Means oxygen should be bound to the hemoglobin. If the hemoglobin is unbounded to the oxygen, that is called as deoxygenated hemoglobin. And if the concentration of this deoxygenated hemoglobin is greater than 5 gram per deciliter, that is called as cyanosis. And the next point one should know in the cyanosis is that साइनोसिस इज नॉट ओनली ड्यू टू द डीऑक्सीजनेटेड हीमोग्लोबिन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इंक्रीज बट इट इज ऑल्सो ड्यू टू द इंक्रीज इन द अमाउंट ऑफ मिथेमोग्लोबिन मिथेमो इफ द मिथेमोग्लोबिन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन राइजेज मोर देन 1.5 ग्राम मोर देन 1.5 ग्राम पर डेसीलीटर देन इट इज ऑल्सो इट ऑल्सो कॉजेज ब्लूइश डिस्कलरेशन ऑफ द स्किन एंड म्यूकोसा एंड इट कैन बी आइदर सॉल्व विथ हेमोग्लोबिन एंड इफ द सॉल्व विथ हेमोग्लोबिन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन राइज इज मोर देन 0.5 ग्राम पर डेसीलीटर देन दैट कैन ऑल्सो कॉज साइनोसिस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल साइनोसिस इज द ब्लूइश डिस्कलरेशन ऑफ स्किन एंड म्यूकोसा सो दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट नाउ द सेकेंड पॉइंट इज द हीमोग्लोबिन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन डीऑक्सीजनेटेड हीमोग्लोबिन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन मोर देन 5 ग्राम और मिथेमोग्लोबिन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन मोर देन 1.5 ग्राम सॉल्व मिथेमोग्लोबिन मोर देन 0.5 ग्राम सो नाउ वी विल डिफ्रेंशिएट और द साइनोसिस इन टू टू टाइप्स दैट इज सेंट्रल साइनोसिस एंड पेरिफेरल साइनोसिस सो रिगार्डिंग सेंट्रल साइनोसिस पेरिफेरल साइनोसिस सो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेंट्रल एंड पेरिफेरल लुक टू फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस वन शुड नो दैट सपोज दैट दिस इज द हार्ट एंड दिस इज द लॉन्ग्स रीजन ओके एंड देयर इज द ऑक्सीजन सेचुरेशन इज गोइंग वाया द हार्ट एंड लॉन्ग्स बोथ ऑर्गेन आर इन्वॉल्व इन द ऑक्सीजन सेचुरेशन मैकेनिज्म द डीऑक्सीजनेटेड हीमोग्लोबिन डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड विच केम इन टू द हार्ट वाया द राइट एट्रियम गोज टू द लॉन्ग्स वेयर इट गेट्स सेचुरेटेड एंड द लॉन्ग्स अगेन सेंड्स बैक द ऑक्सीजनेटेड ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड टू द लेफ्ट एट्रियम एंड आफ्टर देन द ब्लड इज इजेक्टेड टू द पेरिफेरल ऑर्गेन्स वाया द एओर्टा ओके सो दिस वॉज द मैकेनिज्म सपोज दैट देर इज एनी डिफेक्ट इन द सेचुरेशन मैकेनिज्म मीन्स आइदर द डिफेक्ट इज इन हार्ट इट इज अनएबल टू सेंड इट टू द लॉन्ग्स और देर द डिजीज इज इन द लॉन्ग्स रीजन सो ड्यूरिंग सेचुरेशन इट इज अनएबल टू सेचुरेट प्रोपरली द लॉन्ग ब्लड देन दैट इज कंसिडर्ड इन द सेंट्रल मीन्स द सेचुरेशन द वर्ड सेचुरेशन शुड बी रिमेम्बर्ड इफ द प्रॉब्लम इज इन सेचुरेशन देन दैट कॉजेज सेंट्रल टाइप ऑफ साइनोसिस एंड इफ द सेचुरेशन इज नॉर्मल सपोज दैट दिस वॉज एबनॉर्मल सेचुरेशन बट इफ दिस इज नॉर्मल बट द हार्ट इज अनएबल टू पम्प इट टू द पेरिफेरल सर्कुलेशन कार्डियक आउटपुट इज एबनॉर्मल Means saturation was normal, even though the blood is saturated, the heart is unable to pump to the peripheral circulation. Or suppose that the peripheral organs are itself not able to perfuse themselves. So what could be the reason? That could be either vasoconstriction seen in the Raynaud's phenomenon. रिनोल्ड्स फेनोमेनन में क्या होता है कि ठंड की वजह से द डिस्टल फिंगर्स और टोज अंडरगोज वासो कॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन एज अ रिजल्ट द ब्लड डू नॉट पासेस थ्रू दिस वेसल्स एंड एज अ रिजल्ट देर इज साइनोसिस सीन इन द कोल्ड सीजन एंड कोल्ड सीजन और रिनोल्ड्स फेनोमेनन दिस बोथ आर वेरी सिमिलर to each other so the saturation if the saturation is abnormal due to the cardiac cause or lungs cause that is divided into that is called as central sinusitis and if it is peripheral if the cardiac well saturated blood, the heart is not able to pump to the peripheral circulation, or even though it is even though the heart is pumping it properly, if the peripheral organ is not able to perfuse themselves due to vasoconstriction, that causes peripheral type of cyanosis. So some of the logical difference is, suppose that if we provide warm, so which type of cyanosis will be resolved? Obviously, which was caused by the cold season, that will be resolved. Suppose that we are supplying O2 therapy, then which cyanosis will be relieved? Because the saturation, there was problem in saturation in central type of cyanosis, so central cyanosis will be recovered. And what is the site for the central cyanosis? Usually the central cyanosis is seen in central cyanosis kahan dikha jata hai, so one should remember that this is usually seen in mouth region. This is seen in the mucosa of the mouth, it is seen in the tongue. So tongue is usually involved in the central type of cyanosis. And the other difference will be polycythemia and clubbing. Acha, peripheral kahan dekha jayega? Peripheral ka jo jagah hai, that is usually seen in the ear lobule, distal digits. Okay, so periphery mein dekha jata hai, aise digits wagera mein. So and clubbing or polycythemia se kaun involved hoga, kaun related hai, associated with clubbing and polycythemia. So this is for the difference. So this is associated with the clubbing, whereas peripheral is not associated with clubbing. Okay, and air during ABG analysis, there is abnormality seen in the ABG. Mein kis mein abnormal aayega? So obviously the central is abnormal, whereas the peripheral is normal type of ABG analysis is formed. So this is all the symptoms or important clinical presentations seen in the cardiology department. Thank you.